long day. I think I'll just rest for a while first.
Good idea. I'm not sure what to pray for, you mean.
This terrible ordeal. I am afraid of what is going to happen. But this is why I was sent. So not my will, but yours be done.
Lord, I will fight to save you or die trying.
This is not the time for fighting. Are you trying to stop me from following my father's will?
Soldiers are taking Jesus to the house of Caiaphas, the high priest, where he will be tried for blasphemy. Judas is with a group of soldiers, keeping well away from Jesus. Peter and a couple of other disciples follow at a safe distance.
We are the best.
your words and actions, and they will see for you. Girl, go out and fetch your first witness.
Look out! Here comes that Judas fellow.
Thank you.
Why have you brought this man to me? What has he done?
This is Jesus, the Nazarene, who has been perverting the nation and telling people not to pay taxes to the emperor. He has committed blasphemy by setting himself up as the Messiah, and he claims to be a king.
Jesus of Nazareth, I've heard about this man. Take him yourselves and judge him according to your law.
We have done so, but we are not permitted to put anyone to death.
Bring him up here then, so that I can question him.
Sir, I have a message for the governor from his wife.
Urgent message for you, sir, from your wife.
My wife? She knows not to interrupt me in court. What does she say?
She warns you not to have anything to do with this Jesus, whom she describes as an innocent man. She says she has had a bad dream about him. Do you want to send a reply?
Yes. Tell her I understand her concerns, and I will be cautious.
Yes, sir. Take this back to the governor's wife.
Are you the king of the Jews? What about these other charges they bring against you? What's the matter with you? Why don't you answer me? Are you a king?
Are you asking me this because you want to know, or because of what the Jewish people are saying?
Am I a Jew? It is your own people who have handed you over to me. What have you done?
You say, I am a king. My kingdom is not of this world. If it were, my followers would be fighting to prevent me falling into the hands of the Jewish leaders. But my kingdom is far from here.
So you are a king then?
It is you who keeps calling me a king. But I was born and came into the world to bear witness to the truth. Anyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice.
What is truth? Whatever this man is, he's done nothing wrong as far as I can see. I'd like to release him.
These priests are jealous of him, but I have heard that the common people love him. So why not appeal to them directly? As it is Passover time, you could offer to release either Jesus or that bandit who led an insurrection and was found guilty of murder. Barabbas, his name was. A thoroughly nasty piece of work. The people aren't likely to choose him.
I find find no case against this man, but you have a custom that one prisoner is released at Passover. Shall I release for you the king of the Jews or Barabbas, the convicted murderer? What shall I do then with Jesus, who is called the Messiah?
Crucify him! Crucify him! Crucify him! Crucify
him! Why? What evil has he done? I find in him no grounds for the sentence of death. I shall have him flogged and then release him.
If you let him go, you are no friend of Caesar. Anyone who sets themselves up as a king is an enemy of Caesar.
Enough! Tell the girl to fetch me a bowl of water.
Lady, bowl of water and a towel for the governor quickly.
Out here, sir?
Of course out here. Don't argue. Just do it.
I have no choice. I cannot save him from these priests.
But why? You know that those old priests have no real power. They can't force you.
You heard their threat. I can't risk the emperor finding out that I let a would-be king go free. It would mean a return to Rome. And then...
Thank you.
The first station. Jesus is condemned to death. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. We continue to condemn people unjustly today. People are condemned because of the color of their skin, their gender, their beliefs, because they are born with a disability, because they don't conform to our way of thinking. Do we as a society stand up for them and accept them, or do we continue to condemn them over and over again? Prayer. Lord Jesus, teach us to be empathetic toward the feelings of others and to acknowledge the pain that others are going through. Holy Spirit, give me the gift of wisdom to reach out to those suffering around us. Even when things may seem difficult or it may not be the popular thing to do, heal me, Lord, for all the times I have felt denied of something that I felt I deserved, and give me the grace to forgive those who have hurt me. Have mercy on us, O Lord. Have mercy on us.
Lord Jesus, Help me to accept the crosses that you have chosen for me. I know that you only give me those hardships that I can handle. Solomon says that accepting our Lord and rejoicing in our Lord is a gift from God. May we seek your presence, Lord, in all the burdens we carry today. Help us to share our burdens more freely and not be afraid to acknowledge our fears and our pain. Amen. Have mercy on us, O Lord. Have mercy on us.
Committed no crime. He was no
emperor. Only one.
Get back. his face. He doesn't look much like God. He looks helpless. His body gives way under the cross. However, he gets up and takes the next step. The past years have brought us all down to our knees. We have faced many obstacles and hardships, but here he is, God himself, inviting you to place all your sadness, fears, heartache, and loss into his hands and walk. Walk, knowing that he is in control and that with God in our boat, all things are possible. Prayer. Lord Jesus, give me the strength to find beauty in all things. Holy Spirit, give me the gift of faithfulness, that I may welcome your plan in my life and live a life that is full of love, goodness, and peace. Be with me, Lord, every step of the way. May I look to you for strength. Have mercy on us, O Lord. Have mercy on us.
Get back, all of you.
Get back.
We can't just let anyone wander in. Who wants to look? They get in the way. We have a job to do.
A job? You call what you've done to this holy man a job? Animals have no mercy than you do. Barbarians!
You shameless wretch, how dare you speak to me like so?
No, please. I will take her away.
Jesus meets his mother. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. Simon blessed them and said to Mary his mother, Behold, this child is set for the fall and rising of many in Israel, and for a sign that is spoken against, and the sword will pierce through your own soul also, that thoughts out of many hearts may be revealed. And his mother kept all these things in her heart. What a heartbreaking prophecy came true. It gives words to a moment where no words were shed. Just the boy and his mother. A mother stands helpless, watching her son being spat on and whipped. Prayer. Lord Jesus, give us the courage to bring that love into the deepest recesses of our home, to our children and to our spouses, to those places of fracture and disharmony, in our circle of relationships. Mary, our mother, you followed the Lord even when things were hard. Give parents the strength to stand by their children and take the right measures and love unconditionally. Amen. Have mercy on us, O Lord. Have mercy on us.
This blasphemer has been condemned to be crucified.
and he is no longer able to carry his cross. You will carry it for him. Now let's get moving.
No, I am sorry. But I cannot do what you ask.
This is none of my business. You have to find someone else.
I am not asking for your help. I am ordering you to pick up that cross. Now let's go.
Move!
Alright!
Alright! But remember, all of you, that I have not been condemned. That I, an innocent man, has been asked to carry that cross. For the one who is condemned.
Still and wait for me.
Move! Come on! Get him up! Move! Get him on the street! Come on!
Move!
Get him
back!
Get him
back! Move back now!
Leave us alone!
Get aside!
Let us do our job! We have a great company! Leave us
back! Move back!
Move back!
Move back!
Move back!
All of you! Out of here! All of you! All of you! Move
back! Move back!
Move
back!
Move
back!
All of you! All of you!
Move back!
You have a job to do!
Move!
Move back, you all!
Back.
Move back.
For your children. Look at Jesus and listen to his message for us today. Weep for the children who are abused. Weep for the women who are victimized. Weep for men and women who suffer from the tyranny of today's body image that controls their lives and prevents them from feeling lovable. Weep for the young who cannot find a job or a way in life. Weep for the old who are forgotten. Weep for people who starve in the shadow of abundance. Weep for people who are homeless, in exile, or seeking refuge. Weep for them. Pray, Lord, open our hearts to the suffering of all people in our world. Give us the generosity of spirit to help us recognize their pain and the courage to challenge the system that places intolerable burdens on them. Jesus, I am saddened by the suffering that you had to go through for me. I am sorry for the times I have sinned without thinking of you first. Help me to be a faithful Christian and avoid sin for your sake. Have mercy on us, O Lord.
Have mercy on us.
Come on, move away, move away. Move it back, you all. Move away, come on.
Fall again, you lose all hope.
it's not just the weight of the cross that puts him down. He carries the weight of our sins too. Therefore, ask yourselves, if at all I were to be present to witness this, would I help him or would I stand still? Prayer. Lord Jesus, send forth your Holy Spirit to renew in me courage and strength. When our spirit grows weary, to put our unbounded trust in you. Grant me a new beginning, even today. In turn, may we bring your love in a word or action of comfort to another. In their moment of meaninglessness, depression or despair. Have mercy on us, O Lord. Have mercy on us.
You wretch, come on, we are almost there. Your time has come.
Move back, move back, move back, move, move, move back, move, move faster, move, move fast, move fast, move, move. Come on, move fast, move.
Thank you.
teach me to respect the dignity of others. May I always seek justice for others and fight for what is right, and be able to condemn wrongdoers. Let us see, Jesus, it goes around us, and so enable them to reach their full potential. Help me to be a champion of your peace and mercy. Clothe me with your love. Clothe me in your garment of love. Have mercy on us, O Lord.
Have mercy on us.
Who is now at the place called Calvary, which means the place of the sun. Jesus is the third person to be executed today. There are already some addicts who were crucified earlier. It was traditional for the soldiers to take and keep the clothing of prisoners before crucifixion. So Jesus will be stripped and his garments shed. Get your arms up. Get him up to the cross. Over there, nails, usually we just tie them on. Yes, well, this one must have upset someone important. So, its nails and rope for him. Father, forgive them. For they know not what they do. He forgives us. That's a new one on me. If they still speak, they usually curse us. Anyway, let's hoist him up. Come and give us a hand here, will you?
The 11th station. Jesus is nailed to the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. By a holy cross, you have redeemed the world. The soldiers bring sharp nails and tools to pierce his hands. Mercilessly, they hammer them into his body. And Jesus said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Keeping in mind that the word excruciating literally means out of the cross. The pain derived from crucifixion was so intense that the Romans had to create a new word for it. And that word is the root of excruciating. We reflect on Jesus and the excruciating pain he suffered as soldiers pounded thick nails through his hands and feet, the hands that brought healing about many and the feet that walked in search of the lost sheep, are now being brutally bruised. Pain is a part of everyday life. It is what makes us human. We
experience different kinds of pain, be it physical, emotional, and financial. However, so often we cause pain that is felt by others. Sometimes our selfishness is so strong that we are not even aware of the pain we are causing others. Prayer, just like the soldiers, we do cause you so much pain, O Lord. Jesus, through our hands, each time we pull back from helping the needy, and through our feet, for the times we tread the evil path or lead others in doing the same. Through you may we be of service to our fellow men. May our action help them to see you, Jesus. Through the love we share with them, help us to remain faithful to you. Forever my love, forever my heart, forever my life is yours. Have mercy on us, O Lord. Have mercy on us.
Jesus of Nazareth, King of the Jews. We
Yes, you claim to help others, but you aren't so good at helping yourself, are you?
He was deluded and thought he was the son of God. If that were true, why hasn't God saved him?
Oi, Messiah, son of God, king, whatever you are, get me out of here, if you are so clever.
Don't you fear God? We deserve what we got. But this man is innocent. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom.
Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise. Mother, here is your son. John, here is your mother.
Filled it
with vinegar and put it on a reed and gave it to him to drink. But the others said, "Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to save him." And Jesus cried again with a loud voice and yielded his spirit. Prayer. Lord Jesus, be with us in the hour of our death. May those who feel abandoned by God know that He is closer than we can imagine. May those who feel that there is no God at all discover His intimate presence. We pray for the dear departed members of our family and friends. Provide comfort to those who grieve. Have mercy on us, O Lord. Have mercy on us.
Thank you, Nikhil.
Thank you. Prayer. My Jesus, my Savior, We are now at the end of the Via Cross and your ultimate triumph. You showed in your great passion, through grace, love, and mercy, in the face of cruelty and violence. Help me to embrace and trust my Father's will as you did. Let me be the face of your peace for others as you taught. Help me to become fully alive in faith every day in the true spirit of our Lord. You, Jesus, are truly a model of undying love. In my faith, I pray, remake me to now carry on your love for the unloved, your mercy to those who hurt me, your compassion to those who are in need. Lord, we also pray for the people affected by the pandemic. We pray for all decision makers, health workers, even though we are living through uncertain times, we trust in your plan and mercy. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. I love you, Lord. Amen.
Please stand, please, and be comfortable in the church.
Is there any